Now we're on to the labs tab. You'll find all lab results for your patient here. Lab results from the VA Portland Healthcare System and any outpatient VA clinic are recorded here. The upper left box shows the categories of lab results. Your default view shows the most recent results. In the upper central portion of the screen, we can see buttons for oldest, previous, next, and newest. The most recent lab collected is displayed first. Selecting buttons will allow you to go back and forth through the dates. Note the specimen collected in bold lettering below the oldest button. This will show you if the lab is from blood, urine, or another specimen. The collection date and time is listed first on the portion of your screen that shows the lab test and result. You can double-click on any lab value to bring up a graph. You can change the date range here at the bottom of the screen to show you more results. Let's go back to the box in the upper left side of the screen. Clicking on Lab Overview shows all labs collected with their result in the system. These labs are listed in reverse chronological order. Change the date range on the upper portion of your screen. Clicking on the lab displays the result, ordering information, and completion at the bottom of your screen. Now click on Pending Lab Orders. These are all the labs that have been ordered but not yet been collected. That's why they're pending. The worksheet section of the labs is a little bit more complicated. Typically, this is utilized by providers who consistently look at a set of labs for multiple patients, but it can be used if you'd like to see a set of labs in table or graph format. Click on the worksheet. Then in the box underneath laboratory results, we can type in the specimen or ordered lab that we'd like to see. In this case, I want to see the results of this patient's CBC. Choose CBC, click on Add. These are the tests that it's going to display, all the specimens within a CBC. Click OK. And we'll see all the CBC results come back in table format. Again, you can change the date range at the top. We can also click on Graph to see the results in graph format at the bottom of the screen. If you click on Abnormal Results Only, the table will change to show you only the abnormal results in Kathy's CBC. Now I'm going to move on to graph. Graphing is another way to graph lab values. On the left side of your screen, we can select the lab we would like to see graphed. And then we can change the date range down here to show what we'd like to see. And then we can see this patient only has one CBG range, but normally we would see a variety of labs graphed here. And click Close button to go back to the Labs tab. All tests by date allows you to see all tests within your specified date range in linear chronological order. We can change the date range again at the top of our screen. Selected tests by date allows you to choose which lab you would like to see. Again, we'll type in CBC here. Click Add, hit OK, and we can see all the CBC results displayed in linear chronological order. Again, we can change the date range at the top of the screen. Microbiology will show culture and bacteria results on different specimens sent to the lab. You may need to change the date range at the top of your screen to show you the results of a specific lab. In this case, I chose all results. Then you can click on each lab result that is returned and find more information here at the bottom of your screen. Anatomic path displays autopsy, cytology, electron microscopy, surgical pathology, and blood bank results. In this case, our test patient does not have any results. Blood bank will display type and screen information and units of blood products that have been ordered or given. Lab orders all displays the labs ordered for your patient within the specified date range shown at the top of your screen. Again, you can click on each lab to display information at the bottom of your screen. And finally, cumulative shows all lab results in linear chronological order based on a chosen date range. You can use this headings box on the lower left-hand side to sort the lab results on your screen. Again, each of these results headings is a way for you to basically find the same labs. So play around with it and choose which you find is most convenient and easiest for you.